This was an inquest without a death. So rare an occurrence, the coroner said he'd be lucky to conduct an inquiry like it more than once in his whole career. Today it was the job of a jury to decide the ownership of more than 2,500 silver coins unearthed in a Hertfordshire field. About 1,700 years ago, this site outside Stevenage was farmed by a Romano-British family and their retainers. It was a time of regular incursions by Saxon raiders, and it's thought the hoard of coins was buried for safety. Last year, lines on an aerial photograph led the Hertfordshire Archaeological Trust to the field. One coin was revealed, then another.
After we found a dozen or so, we thought we were onto something more than the average find, really. And we decided that we'd search the area quite intensively, and we found 150 coins or so that day.
Eventually, the coin's container was discovered and lifted gingerly from the earth. The clay pot had been broken by modern ploughing techniques. Here it's been glued back together. In all, it contained 2,579 silver coins spanning 70 years of rule by Rome. One coin in particular, minted by the Emperor Percatian in AD 249, is the first ever found in Britain. Well, treasure trove was defined by the coroner as follows. The hoard must have been hidden deliberately, not accidentally lost or thrown away. The owner must be untraceable, and it must consist of gold or silver objects. In the end, all the coins with a silver content of more than 40% were declared treasure trove and go to the British Museum. The rest go to the landowners, property developers who've promised they'll end up in local museums.
There's an awful lot of information will come out of the study of the hoard eventually when the British Museum have done their basic work on it. It's a very important find indeed.
Archaeological work will continue at the site for the next 9 months. It's highly unlikely anything approaching this silver hoard will be found, but to the experts, bits of pottery and bone tell their own exciting story. Paul Larsman, Thames News.